The straightforward way of handling player character's gender in a ChoiceScript game is to make a variable to track that information. This leads to if-else conditional checks whenever the story wants to refer to the player character by pronoun. But as you can see, this takes so much typing each time the pronoun is needed. Since the story is mainly referring to the pronoun, we could skip the conditional check and code the pronoun directly. In this example, the code uses he, him, and his as variable names instead of nominative, accusative, and possessive, because the former set is more intuitive in the context of a story sentence. We cannot easily use she, her, and her as variable names in this situation because the accusative and possessive form of the female pronoun are not distinguishable by letters alone. The third person plural, however, can be used in place of the male pronoun because they, them, and their are distinctive. In fact, you can use any three distinctive variable names to represent the three cases of pronoun in English language ChoiceScript games. The third person plural pronoun presents another challenge. Again, we can use if-else conditional checks to determine whether the verb should be singular or plural, depending on whether the pronoun is singular or plural. But again, that method increases lines of text, and the code can become harder to read due to the added indentation. Multi-replace is a ChoiceScript feature added around May of 2017, and it can shorten the relevant code to one line. In this example, the variable plural is set once, then used alongside some kind of pronoun variable throughout the game. The following code example combines these concerns together and adds one other challenge by allowing the player character to have only the name in place of a pronoun. To differentiate that option from a pronoun that's customized, I create a variable that indicates whether the player character wants a pronoun or not. If you are more conscientious about properly customizing the pronoun for all three cases, you could write more choices and input _text options so that the player character can have their preferred possessive case pronoun. As a final note, if you are new to ChoiceScript, there are two major syntax in this example that haven't been talked about in my previous ChoiceScript videos. First, the ampersand symbol combines two string values together. In this example, I'm adding the apostrophe s to a customized pronoun and a name pronoun for the possessive case. Second, the exclamation mark after the dollar sign tells the engine to display the first letter of the string variable in uppercase. In this example, I set the first letter of the player character name to uppercase so that I don't have to capitalize it each time the name is mentioned in the story.